Hey, it's Terry with Yar Coach. Welcome to T-minus 22 on this 50-day countdown to decluttering, getting rid of the mess in your physical space and your head space, and doing what we can do and not what we can't do during this time. Now, some of you are just now joining this effort, and kudos to you. Thanks. Appreciate all the comments on the YouTube channel. But if you're just joining, what I want to remind us is don't get caught in the struggle, okay? That's a big part of the trap, is struggling. Don't struggle, okay? Just do the assignment for the day. And if you want to go back, I would recommend that you start from the beginning and go back one day at a time. Because what we tend to do is take on too much and not even realize that we're doing it, okay? In an effort, perfection, it's kind of, you need it to be perfect or not at all, and perfection is paralyzing. Let me tell you, if I waited to look perfect or for the technology to be perfect or for the lighting to be perfect, I would not have made one single video that's helping so many of us along the way. So, you know, we are what we are, it is what it is, and we're going to do what we can do and not what we can't do. Today, in an effort to recharge, we're going to get rid of old batteries. I know, everybody's got them floating around. How many times are you going to bang on the remote to get the last juice out of that battery before you finally go, okay, it's given up the ghost, it's dead, I'm going to go get a new one. And a lot of times we don't know what to do with old batteries. We're not really supposed to throw them away. There are ways to recycle them. I would suggest you look into that in your area. Also, too, there are rechargeable batteries now. You may think about that. If you use consistently the same size of battery for several things, you may want to just invest in rechargeable batteries and get that out of your head. It's one of those things that we need. We need batteries for almost everything. And we tend to think somehow they're going to take care of themselves. The other thing I just got this year was a battery storer, and I'll post a picture of it here on this with this video. It's a little thing I bought. I don't know. It wasn't expensive, and it's supposed to show you if batteries are weak or rechargeable and all that. Well, that's fine and good. I haven't really tested that aspect of it, but the main thing is it organizes all the different sizes of batteries, so when I open the drawer, I know exactly what I have. If I buy new batteries, I put them in there, and I know exactly what I have, so I'm not, where's that battery? I just bought batteries. Where are they? Let's not do that anymore, okay? Buy some rechargeable batteries, and while you're at it, recharge yourself by getting rid of stuff, all right? T-minus 22. You're doing well, and thanks for being here, and thanks for joining me, and thanks for making this so much fun, even in the midst of all the uncertainties that surround us, which, as we know, always surround us. Any illusion of control that we have is just that, and we've talked about that in previous videos. So do what you can do today. Live your best life. Just find the old batteries and put them in a box to be taken to the recycler, however you're going to do it. And you can still order some or get some new ones if that's what you need. But just decide. That's the main thing. Decide. This is how I'm going to handle my batteries from now on. Tell everybody in my family, this is where they are. If you need batteries, this is where they are. If you have finished with batteries, this is where they go, in this container that we're going to recycle or dispose of properly. So, T-minus 22, I'll see you all right here tomorrow. Have a great day, and bye for now.